Free jazz horns and the steel drum and everything else.
Yeah. All right, that was a good song.
Who wrote that?
Wally DeVille.
And he's the one that put it out and sang it?
Yeah, under his band Mink DeVille.
Mink DeVille.
Yeah. Yeah, it's one of the lesser known songs. It was on like the third album that... It was one of the only songs on that album that wasn't co-written by, I've heard of Doc Pomus. He was like one of those famous Brill Building songwriters who wrote things like, I think like Save the Last Dance for Me. And
oh, God.
Songs like that. Mm.
He's related to him, or that's who he works with?
I think DeVille had a hit or two.
Yeah. I think Cadillac Walk was the most famous song. That's a song I can imagine Jeff Belby doing.
It's got that kind of, baby, just the Cadillac walk.
very typecast. What kind of song is Jeff Belby?
Well, I've gotten some good Jeff Belby lessons lately.
Yeah?
Learning all kinds of good songs.
Oh, wow.
They're doing a get-together at the Voodoo Lounge.
Oh, how cool.
Yeah, we just did the Fog Fest in Pacifica 4 hours a day. Our fingers were killing us on the second
goodness.
Day.
But the Voodoo Lounge.
We repeated a lot of songs, but I think we got about five good hours of music.
That's really good.
Fog Fest as in K-Fog.
I do all the Dylan. He did his mandolin. He took out.
Wow. Wow, people liked it too, I bet.
Yeah, between the two guitars, harp and or mandolin, it always seemed to me, it was, you know, it was nice and full for just two guys.
Wow.
If I say so myself.
Yeah. Wow, I wish I could have videotaped it. I bet that was hot.
It can't be everywhere.
Yeah, it can't be everywhere.
Well, it was just, we were just the
someday,
street
though,
musicians there. Yeah, we were just sitting, you know, on the street, just playing. We have our people cruising back and forth.
That's on mission.
Got good reactions.
Oh, yeah. Doing, okay.
People donate or give you tips or whatever.
Yeah, we played for tips.
Yeah.
We did all right.
I've
done better on North Beach. I think we netted about 60
each.
No.
Oh, okay, 30 each. That's not bad.
Yeah, for two, it should, you know, could have been a little better. First day went really well. Second day just seemed slow. But also, all the merchants said it was slow, so people just weren't spending.
Yeah.
What we're doing for the love.
That's me.
That's what I'm talking about.
While he's doing that, can I sit outside for a second and play behind this? I have to get my wrist kind of hard thing.
Is it like my friend Tim, who did a lot of the hand percussion, who did most of the hand percussion on this, is like, he has another thing called a tar that's a little bigger.
Yeah, right. Yes.
And those you kind of have to hold them to the sun for a while
to
get them ready. Is that, is this like that?
This is in the same genre, the frame drum.
Yeah.
Sometimes people hold the tars like this. They play like this, right? Some of them have shakers lined in and they actually jiggle up in the air. And I saw some guys at St. John from some Kurdish masters play and I was going like...
Yeah, wow, I bet that was cool.
Oh, this guy had drums about this big, all the shakers. I talked about getting 20 sounds. Oh yeah, it was Tim,
like with the guitar, sometimes he does things like, he'll do like a fill by scratching it.
Thank you.
be speeding up like crazy too, because I get excited.
What? You don't play like a metronome?
Mm-hmm. There was this guy on. We saw. We went to. Kind of spontaneously went up to see Electric Color Wheel at this place called the Canvas Cafe. They opened for this guy. Oh, God, what was his name? Austin Willisie. And he had, like, for percussion, he had a guy doing, like, human beatbox stuff. Just, like, doing all knife drumming. What I can tell.
The first half, because it's the first time I've heard this song. Yeah. I was in time, but I wasn't in psychic sync. But toward the end, I was getting in a real good sync, so I got an idea of that.
That's to be expected on the very first run through.
All right, well, here we go. Now I'm a little bit warmed up here.
Cool.
I haven't played all day, so it's tough. All right.
We'll go ahead and play for me a little bit.
Oh, sure.
What's that?
Yeah.
Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4. Drive.
box you were doing at the end. That was very... Yeah, you didn't hit the M's those times. You were still hitting the ones. But maybe we can, I don't know. If that was really good, maybe we can just do punches or even just...
We just go to those...
or just mute them, I don't know.
Yeah, we could possibly just go to those breaks and just punch in the breaks.
Yeah.
It was good otherwise.
But,
I
thought you were very on.
Hmm.
Mostly, yeah. How did it sound to you when on the chorus he was kind of hanging back and just hitting and...
Sounded pretty good. I have to hear it again.
Yeah.
Yeah, because...
It would probably...
It all depends on how it's mixed,
yeah. Right, huh?
Yeah. Hmm. Because the other percussionists or the other rhythms mm-hmm. were really like dynamic and really mm-hmm. pushing the beat a little bit there. Uh-huh. I decided just to back out of it, rather than try and match it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'd have to practice with it for an hour or so.
Yeah. Well, that might make for good accents doing it that way.
Hmm, okay.
Should we listen in there or listen here?
Yeah, sure, listen in here.
Well, let's come to the control room.
Oh, okay.
So can I bring the wire with me with the camera or no?
If you bring it to the control room, you won't need the wire.
Slow train. Mr. West Coast dealer, he wants to front for you. So experienced and all, he knows just what to do. He says you must be tired of the street, my friend. Here's a place for you to rest.
Trying to get more voices doing that part.
And the price is never mentioned until he gets your best. Always smartest hands and nobody to blame. Nobody but yourself for being pulled in a can into that.
It's kind of like that. Suddenly you're kind of like leaping. And I kind of like how this is just like, whoa! And then back in. Yeah.
So you're new in town and you want to meet some friends. Pressure cookers working on pressuring you into doing things. And if they get you cornered, they'll be coming around again, and that's for sure.
It seemed very much in sync.
Mm-hmm. Always spotless hands and nobody to blame. Nobody but yourself for being pulling again into that slow train. Slow train. Mr. West Coast dealer, he wants to fight.
So that'll be easy. We could just go in and tackle that one little thing.
Yes.
some piss here, and boom, we're back on.
They're all pressure cookers working on pressuring you into doing things. Be coming right in, and that's for sure.
Take it till you try.
Everything they touch just seems to waste away. Always the smartest hands and nobody to blame. Nobody but yourself would be and pulled and again into that. Suffer being pulled and I get into that slow drain.
Now, what I'd rather do is this, okay? Right before those breaks happen, you kind of play like a abbreviated version of what you're playing. You kind of go.
Touch just seems to waste away. Oh, nobody but your suffer being
you right
pulled and I get into that slow drain.
It's one, two, three, four, one. So it's like one, two, one, and two, and three, and four, and.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. And that's what's going to happen both of those times.
Okay.
So right in the chorus, it's the chorus, right?
Yeah, da, da, first and third chorus. Da, da, bum, the second chorus da, goes into that other part. Bum, bum, da,
da, da. So basically, you'll hear yourself play these two kind of abbreviated parts. Abbreviated meaning you're playing less. You're not playing the standard.
Right. Nobody to blame, nobody but yourself for being pulling again into that slow train. That slow train.
And I'll get you out. So that click click, you'll be out.
Sure. Sure.
Okay. Rape is so misunderstood. Whisper about drugs that are 100 yards away. And if she gets you cornered, she won't be satisfied. And everything around her just seems to fly apart. Always spotless hands and nobody to blame. Nobody but yourself for being pulled in again into that slow train. Slow train. Mr. West.
I think that was good.
All right.
Sure.
Raise spotless hands and nobody to blame. Nobody but yourself for being pulled in again into that slow train.
It was soft. It was there, but it was softer and dynamic.
Is it softer and dynamic?
Yeah.
Huh. Noticeably so.
I
listened
almost to it by itself.
Okay, that's it. I wasn't sure exactly where I put you in. Is it lagging a tiny bit, or...?
It's very, very subtle. If you want to do it again, that's...
Sure. Let's do it.
Okay. Right.
Here we go.
She can hear you sniff or whisper about drugs that are 100 yards away. She won't be satisfied.
was very good.
Yeah, got it then.
That's not good to me.
I think the Davis feed is lame.
Nobody but yourself for being pulling again into that slow train. Slow train.
Are you just storing?
The tape is good.
Can I get an idea of the feel? Or maybe we should just listen to the track? I don't know.
Okay.
Well, the track's queued up already. As we speak. That would probably be playing with the mix. What would you prefer? I mean, just strum it live first, or just hear the track?
We can hear the track now.
Let's hear the track as it's on. Yeah. Okay.
You have it on.
Erto played this drum for the first time. He's a master at playing this drum.
Oh, Erto plays that?
Yeah. Uh-huh. I mean, besides all kinds of other percussion mm-hmm. stuff.
Oh. Where'd you see him?
The Yoshi's.
Those patterns don't look easy, actually. Like, even though they're, yeah.
It's hard to know when to substitute the sound that you need.
Right.
Sure. Do you?
Yeah.
You haven't tried playing along with it yet.
Right. So. Yeah.
I'll just let you play with it.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. No. I can barely hear you.
He wants to know whether the Davis speed is okay.
If your level's
feel?
That's about feel.
Okay.
I was going to play with possible dynamics in the bridge.
Sure, oh yeah, good. Oh yeah, great. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Big.
That really, believe me, that really helps. The conductor.
I missed my calling.
You have a con.
You haven't missed anything, honey. You're enjoying it.
A little bit closer. Do you think the part's right?
I think we're still settling in.
I'm wondering if it's a little busy.
Oh, okay.
Because the original drum part is pretty minimal. It's just boom, boom, ba, 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 ba. Boom, boom. And there's a couple of times in there I was hearing you speed up. It's in the intensity. Mm-hmm. The beat is pretty steady, but it just kind of feels like it gets a little bit faster.
Okay.
But I think that...
Yeah, when I was like...
Well, I was really following him, but...
When I was doing the expansive thing, it was like, it's still the same
bigger
pulse, okay.
But...
Well,
just like
I'll do your suggestion.
I think,
and do it.
Sure. Maybe just a little bit more minimal. Because there's a lot of stuff that you actually that you're not hearing. There's like keyboards and other stuff in it.
Oh, okay.
Some kind of float. There's a floaty keyboard, and there's the
which the isn't rhythmic, but I just think that there's a lot of stuff in there that's like if you it would work better if it was just more just like kind of like on the bottom, pulled down the end.
Yeah.
Okie dokie.
Okay. Yeah. Shall we try one?
Sure,
why not?
Okay.
One, two, three, four.
pretty darn good.
The first four beats in the intro, I thought may have been a weak intro for me.
Let's go back.
Do those, that part again. It's getting out. That's the trick. Yeah,
I see.
I can get it like right on. Like it sounds to me like it's just for a whole bar.
Right, the whole
first bar, and then there's a little bit of a pause before you start the other one. So what I'll do is I'll just put you in for that first bar.
Okay.
And then just get you out.
Okie dokie.
Try to leave a pause. So I go. This is like 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, it's two bars, isn't it?
Right, right.
One more time.
Yeah. Hold on. It's first two chords.
It's two bars, right?
Those two, then. Okay.
Okay.
So here we go.
Well, give us a good count.
Yeah, did you hear it last time?
Not when you were just doing it. No.
Oh, no, I didn't do that at all.
Yeah.
This time you will.
Okay. As soon as I have one.
Oh, wow. Love it. That'd be an absolute pleasure.
Yeah. Best room's back that way.
Oh, yeah. By the way, there's around that corner to the left, there's like a little sort of like elevated shower stall area. That's where the toilet is.
Yeah. That was cool. Oh, boy. That was, normally I play for like at least like an hour and a half in the morning before I have to record in the evening or so.
Oh.
So everything's loose.
Oh, no.
And because I had to do a work, I had to do all kinds of other stuff.
Caught you fresh.
And,
so, but actually, you got your muscles nicely loosened up.
Oh, yeah. She really out. That's for sure. Oh, yeah. Normally, just from 20 minutes of playing, I would be able to feel it in here, you know.
Oh.
Holding it up is tough enough, but
carpal tunnel syndrome.
Oh, hopefully not. Hopefully. But your songs are fun, man. You're a great performer.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think so too. Good writer too, huh?
Hey, excellent. Hey, certain.
Yeah, I actually wrote that last one.
Oh my goodness, hey, there you go.
Wow. So.
Well, thank you so much.
All right, well, that was good. That's a great sounding thing. That is really neat. I love Brazilian amazing music.
Oh yeah.
There's a guy around the corner that teaches Brazilian drums.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't know who he is, but I hear him every once in a while, and he teaches kids. It's great. And they participate in the parades and stuff like that, and they do the carnival. But I just recently have been discovering some pretty cool Brazilian stuff. But mostly Tropicália stuff.
Yeah,
I really like that.
60s.
And but there's other stuff too, like Gilberto Gil and Tom Zay, who's just wacky, but I like him just because he's just. Have you heard him?
No.
He is really out there.
Wow.
He's more like on the
Tom Zay.
Yeah, he's one of the guys that was in the Tropicália movement in the 60s. And he kind of dropped out, I guess. He just kind of completely...
He didn't get it put in jail like some of these
No, I think he might have left the country and then come back later. But he was pretty outspoken character, and that wasn't good at that time. But there was also a lot of other stuff going on. He just made a big splash a couple years ago because
David Byrne discover him.
Well, yeah, right. Yeah, he brought him back out again.
And I've never even heard his stuff though, Tom's.
Oh, it's great. It's totally great. It's really, it's like very industrial. He uses all kinds of sounds, like electric drills and just, you know, but within the context of traditional Brazilian music.
That's,
like Gilberto Gil does that too.
I was making a joke about industrial samba because of the sound your camera was getting, but.
No, there's a piece where he's got like, just these sounds, they're kind of really disjointed, but they're all perfectly in time. You hear this electric drill and then hammers and then this industrial site and then, you know, he's playing acoustic guitar and he's got a lot of people singing.
Wow. You know what's amazing about that is that
test department Brazilian, finds the clave.
Yeah.
The Brazilian samba has like 9 or 10 distinct rhythm patterns. And if you have another sound doing those instruments,
yeah,
it's still going to work.
It doesn't matter. Yeah.
So he figured that out.
Yeah.
He figured that out. And it's, that's a great idea. That's a great idea. And the samba is so infectious and powerful.
Yeah, yeah.
In your midsection.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, well, the Brazilians use it for miles of carnival marching.
You know,
miles and miles. And
even
more.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, boy.
There's another Gilberto. I think it's Gilberto Gil. I have a record of that. Does the same. He does another thing like that, where all these guys were listening to real contemporary music when they were doing their own traditional samba and other forms. And they brought in the wackiest stuff. I mean, some of it just sounds so foreign because you'd be listening, it'd be really nice samba with the traditional instruments, kind of like a nylon string guitar, a clave, and one of those, and a couple of things. And then they'll just bring in a bunch of like fuzz box guitars and things that you're just going, whoa. But they do it very beautifully.
That's like those Matantes.
Yeah, Matantes did it too, but see, they did it at the same time, Gilberto Gil and a couple of those.
They were like younger people who got adopted by those people, kind of.
They did, yeah. They did songs by all those people on that record that I got recently. There, they all kind of play together, and it's the greatest stuff. It's because it's so beautiful, but at the same time, you know, you just don't know what to expect, what they're going to do next. You know,
that's direction.
A little more pronounced.
Tones to contrast with those high tones.
I kind of like that down. I like down. Okay.
But maybe when it gets to that chorus with different chords, hit some higher notes.
Yeah,
there.
I think that I need to move up when you do that C. I need to be up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Do I try one?
Are you feel like trying one?
Mm-hmm.
When I go 1, 2, 3, 4, that's when you can come right in.
It just didn't sound like that. I mean, but
I know,
right.
But it's,
okay,
it's like
right.
A weird
all right.
Cue,
yeah, I mean, okay.
But it's true.
Okay. I trust you.
Yeah.
Is your level good?
Davis, is your
level
good?
Oh, yes. Sorry. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Okay. Can we try one?
Absolutely.
Get into that slow drain.
Drain until you're dry.
Slow drain.
Doing things.
It's
a little,
like, shaky at times.
Warm-ups are good.
Oh, yeah, warm-ups are good. And sometimes you get a take doing the warm-up. Mm-hmm.
But, you want to do it again?
Yeah.
What do you think, Kim?
Do you have, like, a... Are you... Is a part coming to... is a structure coming to mind, or are you just going to, like, go random?
I can... I think I got something on that, that I'll follow that again.
Okay. You know, yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Cool. I didn't hit that change there at the end, and I didn't like the way that ended either.
Okay. Well, then we can probably just start in the same place and do it a little more with a little more confidence.
All right.
We'll be there.
And then do it with joy.
And do it with joy. And then do it with pain, and then around back to joy again.
Yeah.
I feel this profound
it.
Sadness.
Yeah, you feel that way too.
Pain
I don't know.
Let's try it. Ready? You ready?
We are ready.
Okay.
Are we? Yes.
Slow drain.
Drain until you're dry.
Slow drain. Pressure cookers working on pressuring you into doing things.
Drink until you're dry.
And if they get you corners, they'll be coming round again, and that's for sure.
Drink until you're dry.
Everything they touch just seems to waste away. Always spotless hands and nobody to blame. Nobody but yourself for being pulled in again into that. Slow drain.
Drain until you're dry.
Slow drain. Slow drain.
Drain until you're dry.
Slow drain.
Drain until you're dry.
Slow, 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 slow drain.
Dub, 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 dub,
dub. He's the Nag, the Nag, the Nag, man.
Insist for this label to avoid imitation.
Buy from reputed dealers only.